So we found the queen on this frame. So what we're gonna do is mark her and clip her. I'm just putting my finger underneath there to keep her from going through. Right, there she's coming back. First of all, we need to talk a little bit about how to pick up the queen. So what I like to do to pick up the queen is approach her from behind, get my fingers right down to the comb, and then gently squeeze on her thorax. Not on her abdomen at all. Her abdomen is very tender, so we can't squeeze on her abdomen. But we can squeeze on the thorax. And then we just lean the frame out of the way, and we transfer to our other hand. We could transfer the queen back and forth, handling her by the thorax. I want to position the queen in between my fingers, and I'm just wiping my fingers off to get some wax and propolis and honey off. Then I'll wipe my other fingers off there. And we've positioned her nice and high in between my index and thumb. We use a latex or water-based paint pen and just brace my hands together and draw a nice blue dot on her there. There's a color code for marking queens. This is a last year's queen, so it's 2015 queen, and that year it was blue. Now we use a pair of blunt tipped scissors, and we just going to reposition her a little bit there. We want to clip the left wing on an odd year and the right wing on an even year. So again, my arms are braced on my legs, and I just lift up that left wing, and we cut right where the inside margin of the wing changes angle. There's an angle there, and you cut right at that angle, and just make sure there are no feet or legs sticking in the way, and then snip that off. So now she's marked and clipped, and we'll put her into a cage, and we'll let that paint dry for a few moments. It's already looking pretty dry because it's on a nice warm day here, but we'll put her in here to let that paint dry a bit, and we just lay the queen on top of the frames until we put the frame back in and we're all ready to release her. We get this frame into position first, just so there's no opportunity that she could possibly be crushed with the frames being moved around. And then we'll pick up that cage and we will release the queen. If there are bees on the surface, we just gently brush them away. We don't rub because the queen's feet can be sticking out through these holes and we could shear them off if we're rubbing the bees off. But I'd like to get most of the bees off the cage so that when we go to release her, we can just focus on her. We just pop that cage open and hold the lid back so the lid can't interfere. Then we shake her into her hand, like so. And then it's easy to watch her go down in between the frames when we release her. So we can either just put her in or shake her off her hand like so and watch her go down in between the frames. So now we know she's nice and safe, and she's barked, so she'll be easier to find next year. That clipping helps to prevent her from swarming, but it's also a back up for the paint marking. If the paint happens to come off, we know that if it's a clipped queen, that it's still the same queen. So that's how we handle queens, cage them, mark them, and clip them, and then again release the queens when we're finished. It's really handy to have marked queens because it makes it so much easier to find them when we're looking for them.